Chapter 3. Law's chambers were large and resplendent. The Golden Emperor had clearly sent details of her old chambers to the Daleks here, as it almost completely matched her old quarters. There were red walls, and various workout apparatus was arranged around the room. And in the centre of the room was a large bed. It was nothing fancy, just a soft mattress and a cover, but it was comfortable. She sat on it now, considering her predicament. This new world was strange and dangerous. She felt alone. She supposed all Daleks felt alone in a way. They were not social creatures when it came down to it. She untied her hair and let it fall down to her shoulders. She thought about Ryuk. He had been tasked with being general of a newly formed conquest army, Zero. This would be comprised of reclaimed Daleks deemed beyond use. He seemed content with this, but she was not. Whilst they had not been what you would call close, they had seen each other fairly regularly before, but now she did not know when she would next see him. This made her feel sad, although she would never admit this to him. She heard something outside her chamber door, and got up to investigate. Outside her chambers stood a Dalek. She recognized it as the one Zeon had commanded when first she had landed. "It's Stork, isn't it?" she asked. The Dalek's eye looked at her impassively.
"Yes, General,"
Stork replied flatly. What are you doing here?" Law prodded.
"I am guarding this area,"
Stork stated. "Why?" she pressed. Stork twitched a little now. She thought he looked faintly embarrassed.
"After the loss of our last general, it would reflect very badly were we to lose another. Therefore, I am standing watch in case of incursion."
Law was not sure this was all there was to his actions, but she nodded in understanding. "I see. Thoughtful, but not necessary. I can defend myself against any possible threats. Proceed with your other duties." As she said this, she got the impression she was being watched.
"Move aside, General!"
Stork called out. Law leapt aside deftly, but before she knew what was happening, Stork was firing at her bed. She wondered what he was doing, until she heard a small squeal, and saw one of the cyber creatures attempting a hasty getaway. Stork fired again, and this time destroyed the cyber insect, which burst into flames, setting her bed on fire. Foam sprinklers deployed automatically and put out the fire. Law strode towards the remains and examined it. As she did, a second cybermite crawled onto Stork's casing, attempting to burrow inside.
"Emergency! Emergency!"
cried out Stork. Law turned quickly, seized a small hatchet she had stored under her mattress, and rolled towards Stork, slicing it into his skirt section. The hatchet embedded into Stork's armor and destroyed the cybermite within. Stork's eye stalk was looking down at her in disbelief.
"You saved me,"
he said with something strange in his voice. Law grunted as she pulled the hatchet out. It was stuck in there good and proper. It left a crack in Stork's shell, which sparked slightly. "You saved me first. We're even. Sorry about the damage," she said.
"It is nothing. We must make sure there are no more of those creatures here,"
Stork said. Law went back to searching her room. "How did they get in?" she said idly. Stork nudged a door with his manipulator arm. The door led to something humans and hybrids needed, but Daleks did not. A bathroom. Humanoids need running water for basic things like washing, drinking, etc. Law saw what he was implying. "The water pipes," she guessed.
"A logical deduction,"
Stork replied. Law considered that if Stork had not alerted her to his presence, she would have been planning to go for a short nap. She did not think she would like letting those creatures roam her room whilst she slept. "Order a full sweep of the water mains. If they tried to attack me, they might also target the slaves. Meanwhile, I want to see the hibernation unit Zeon mentioned."
"As you command, General Law,"
Stork replied. Outside the Ninth Conquest Army's base compound was a large wall that ran around its perimeter. Along the border of it, Daleks patrolled. Three such Daleks were manning an entrance gate. One of them stated,
"No sign of any Cybermen. We haven't seen any of them for days."
"It makes me nervous," replied the second Dalek, Freenull. "In a firefight, I know where the enemy is, but I do not like this waiting."
"These Cybermen are crafty," said the third. "They wait and watch for a way in and exploit any weaknesses they can find. Fortunately, we are the Cyberstompers and have no known weaknesses."
"Agreed,"
replied the first Dalek. Freenull did not. He looked around at his fellows. They seemed calm in the face of their unseen enemy. But the very thought of the Cybermen sent a chill down this Dalek's rear panel. He had seen the Cybermen tear a Dalek apart with their bare hands. The mutant was pulled out and was helpless, thrashing around as the Cybermen looked at it with its blank, black holes for eyes. That Dalek had been in Freenell's unit since his birthing, and to come so close to the destruction, to witness what could have happened to him, had left him traumatized. He thought about this now, about the rush of feeling he had been unable to define. Fear. He knew that was what it had been. But among the Ninth Conquest Army, or any Dalek army, the word fear was a dirty word. Fear was something humans let control them. But Daleks had no such weakness. Didn't they? As he thought about this, he saw something scurry along the surface of the wall. His eye stalk shot up.
Did you see that?
Freenol asked. The other two Daleks looked.
I see nothing, replied the first.
Neither do I,
concluded the second. But Freenol saw it again. It scurried down the wall, a silver creature. He had seen them burrow into Dalek casings and sabotage systems, killing the mutant in mere rels. He fired at the insect.
Hold your fire!
Shouted the first Dalek. But more cyber insects were coming, scurrying down the wall like a silver tide.
There! There! They are coming! Exterminate! Exterminate!
Freenol panicked. He fired again and again, but all too soon the creatures were upon them. Law and Stork saw the altercation as they approached. Law strode towards them. What is going on here? She asked, but Freenol did not respond.
Exterminate!
He cried. Seeing the silver insects scurry over the Dalek to his left, he opened fire, and the Dalek was engulfed in flames. Stork watched as Law stretched her wings and flew at speed into the third Dalek and lifted it out of the way of Freenol's blaster fire. She placed the Dalek down a small distance away. Stork tried to reason with Freenol, who was apparently attacking nothing.
Trooper Freenol, cease fire. There are no enemies here.
But Freenol was spinning now.
They are all around me! Help me! Help me!
Stork leveled his weapon. Law looked at him.
He is crazed, General,
Stork said.
He must be destroyed.
Wait, that isn't necessary. Watch. She pulled a small device out of her pocket and extended a wire from it. She placed it into Freenol's casing. Law did not know that something else was also watching. From the wall, a cybermite watched her actions and relayed it to the nearest Cyberman, who watched as if it was right there. Law pressed something on the device, and a moment later, Freenol was still. The Cyberman listened as Stork asked.
What did you do?
Just a temporary deactivation. Something General Ryuk of Conquest Army Zero showed me. It's a failsafe system that can be used if a Dalek is malfunctioning. It sends a signal through the travel machine and deactivates it. The mutant is placed into suspended animation until it can be analyzed and repaired. The Cybermite's vision zoomed in on the device, which Law now removed from Freenol. The third Dalek, which she had saved, looked at her gratefully. Have him taken for psychological evaluation at once, Law commanded.
I obey,
replied the Dalek. The Cyberman considered its options as Law and Stork exited the wall through the entrance gate. Now was the time to act.